Hello everyone, welcome to ThemeWinter. In this video, I am going to explore total settings menu for the WP Eventin. Before starting the main tutorial, I would like to inform you we already have video on how to create speaker, schedule and event. You can check them, link is available on our description. So let's start with the settings. First settings, sell on WooCommerce. Before enabling this option, let me show you how our event looks like. Here is our event page and there is no ticket selling option available, and we want to sell ticket from our event page. In order to sell ticket from our event page, we need to enable sell on WooCommerce option, and after that we need to save it. Let me move to the event page again and refresh the event. Now the registration form, I mean the ticket selling option, is available. One more thing I'd like to let you know, if you do not have WooCommerce installed in your website, this registration form will not be added. So before enabling sale on WooCommerce, make sure you have installed WooCommerce in your website. After that, the next settings is select date format. This is basically how you want to show your date in event page. So let me select one format. After that, the select time format. You can select 24 hours or 12 hours time format. After that, select event expiry point. So you can select a starting date or ending date. If you select a starting date, this expiry point will count from the starting date. And if you select ending date, then this expiry point will count from the ending date. And this is related to the next settings, disable registration after event is expired. So you can disable the registration for your event when the date will be expired. The next settings, select event template, is basically how the event will be look like in our live landing page. And the select speaker template, you also have option to select some speaker template, how the speaker will look like in speaker landing page. And the next settings, we are moving to the include into search. If you want to search your event, you can select yes, or if you do not want to search this event, you can select no. Basically, if you have more than one event, then yes is better option for you. The next option is required login. If you want your attendee to get login first before purchasing any ticket, then you can click here. And if you want to hide expired event, then you also can click here. And the next settings, price level text. So you can set a customized text for your ticket price. After that, the event slug name, speaker slug name, basically these are the URL for your event and speaker. You can change the default URL for the event and for the speaker. If you change it, then don't forget to save the changes and update the permalink from the WordPress settings menu. If you do not update the WordPress permalink, then sometimes you may get 404 not found error. And the last settings for this tab, color option. You can select primary color, secondary color. Let's select some color so that we can understand how it works. Alright, so now let's save the changes and let's see in live page how it works. So the date and time format has been changed, and you see the ticket customized text is available, and the color we just changes here, it affected. Also the color has affected here in speaker schedule. The event is looking good. Now let's move to the next tab under Eventin settings menu. Here the details option is available. You can hide many components from your event. Let me show you all together so that it saves all of our time. So we can hide the event date, after that hide the time, then we can hide the event location, then we can hide the total seat number, hide attendee count, after that we can hide the organizers, also we can hide the schedule details, and the last option we can hide full address. You can hide all this option, or you can hide one or as much as you need. So let's save the changes and let's see how the event is look like now. Now the event does not have any of the information that we hide from this settings menu. Alright, so let's move to the notification settings. Under the notification tab, you can set your custom email. It will use for sending all the notification emails. It means the event ticket processor will get all notifications from this email. After that, let's move to the attendee tab. Here, if you enable the attendee registration, then all the attendee need to register first before purchasing any ticket. If you want to send your ticket manually, then you can click on disable ticket email option from here. On the registration form, you can require the phone number, you can require the email address. Also, you can remove attendees after fill the payment. This option is important, like if you set 3 days, so your attendee need to pay within 3 days after purchasing any ticket. Now let's see how the full functionality works. I'm saving the changes, and now let's try to buy one ticket from the add to cart. So I'm clicking here and see it asks me to register first, and the name, email address, phone number is required. Now I'm changing one more settings, that is we are removing this phone number required option. Save changes. Let's refresh the registration form and see the phone number is hidden from this registration form. So in this way you can customize your registration form. After that, let's move to the Zoom tab. Here in Zoom, if you want to use Zoom in your event, then you need to enable this option. After that, you need to set API key and secret key. Then check the connection. Don't forget to save changes to check the connection. How you can get this API key and secret key? We already have the documentation and the link is available in the description. Don't forget to check it out before working here in Zoom tab. Now we are going to explore all the shortcode from the ThemeWinter website, because this will help you to understand better. First shortcode, event search filter. You can search your event like location, event category, and many more. After that, the next shortcode, event list and event tab. Let's explore them from the ThemeWinter website. So here is our event, and then here is our event tab. For the event, this is grid style 1. After that, we also have second style, grid style 2. Here it goes. Now let's move to the tab style. This is the tab grid style 1. Now we also have event tab style 2, and here it goes. Alright, we also have speaker list shortcode. So let's explore it here from the site. Here is the speaker. Let's click it. This is the speaker, and we also give the example of our shortcode. Here is another style for the speaker. Let's move to the next shortcode. We have schedule tab and schedule list shortcode. Let's get back to the ThemeWinter site again. Here is the schedule. Now this is the schedule list style, and the example shortcode is here. After that, we have schedule tab style. Example shortcode is available here. Alright, now let's explore one shortcode, how it works. So I'm simply copying the shortcode and pasting it in a new page. Saving the page. And here it comes. The shortcode is for searching the event. That's all for the free settings module. Hello everyone, welcome once again from the ThemeWinter. So far we talked about the free settings of the WPEventin, but now it's time to dive into the pro settings menu for the WPEventin. Now here in plugin list, I already installed Eventin Pro. For getting all the settings I'm going to show, make sure you have WPEventin Pro. Now let's move to the settings menu. Under the general tab, you will get multiple event template and speaker template in our pro version. So let me select template 3 for event template and template 2 for speaker template. Let's save the changes. Now refreshing the speaker template, and this is a new design for the speaker. Refreshing the event template, this comes with a new design from the WPEventin Pro. Now the next setting, you can enable licensing and avoid manual updates for the plugin. The documentation link is in description, check if needed. Moving to the next details tab, under the details tab you will get all the pro elements, hide and display option. Like you can hide frequently asking question, you can hide social media link, you can hide related event from here. Don't forget to save the change if you hide any of the elements from this given list. Well, our next tab is notification. Under the notification tab in WPEventin Pro, you will have option to send reminder email to the ticket purchaser. Let's say you have set 2 here, so WPEventin will send one reminder email to the ticket purchaser 2 days before the event happened. Now you can customize your email body, and you also have option to add event details inside the email body. Don't forget to save the changes. After that, our next tab is attendee. Here you will get one extra field for event attendee registration. Let's say you want to get zip code for the event attendee. So adding zip code here, input type will be number, and you can add one sample zip code. After that, save the changes. Now let me show you how this extra field works. I'm going to try one ticket purchasing from the event and see the zip code field is available here. In the same way, you can add extra field as many as you want. After that, we have shortcode option. Under the shortcode option, you will get all the pro widgets shortcode available. I'm going to show you all the shortcode from the ThemeWinter website so that you get better idea how the output is going to be. Moving to the ThemeWinter website, here we have schedule list and schedule tab. After that, we have speaker list. We also have speaker slider. For the event, we have event list, event tab, and we also have counter timer. Let me show you one by one. This is our schedule list style. We have multiple schedule list style for the event. After that, we have tab style. Inside tab style, we also have multiple style. For the speaker style, we also have multiple speaker style. Also, we have multiple slider style for the speaker. Moving to the next, we have list style for the event. And tab style for the event listing. Alright, let me show you the counter for the event. You can set different style time counter in your event page. So these are the pro widgets in WPEventin. We also have other pro widgets. Don't forget to check the ThemeWinter website. Now let me show you one shortcode how it works. I'm going to select speaker slider, copying the shortcode and pasting it in a new page. Now I need to update this categories ID. For getting category ID, I'll get back to the settings After that, I'll click on speaker category, and here you see the ID number is 3. So I'm going to update this ID number is 3. Updating the page. So this is the output for the shortcode speaker slider pro widgets. For better understanding, I'm going to show you one more shortcode, but this shortcode is little bit different. This time I'm going to show you event schedule tab shortcode. Let's copy the shortcode, paste it. Now I need to update the ID, so I'm getting back to the settings. After that, I'll click on event schedule. Then we have schedule ID 52, 58 and 59. Here I'm updating the ID. Let's update the page. Now let's see. Alright, this is our schedule. Now the difference is, when you will update this schedule, you will take this ID, but for the speaker, you will have to take speaker categories ID, and for the event, you will have to take event categories ID. Please be careful when you will work with event and speaker, because on that time, you will have to take event categories ID and speaker categories ID. So that's all for today's video. If you have any question for the WP Eventin, don't forget to comment below. We'll reply as soon as possible. Also, ThemeWinter team is continuously updating the widgets, style and many more. So don't forget to check the latest version from our ThemeWinter website. Thank you.